Moving on to the last part, let's take a look at this product model. The characteristics of the product. The first one is iStack. So the feature of this iStack, in fact, what function is it? Starting from this issue, we see in traditional networking. In traditional networking, as we know in layer 2 networks, there may be loops, there may be issues like broadcast storms. So how to solve this? Through this MSTP form, through spanning tree, in this way, I can unify its some links. Blocking is to ensure that our network has no loops, but it also has a drawback, which is that it wastes a lot of bandwidth. Some of my effective links cannot be utilized. You can see this is a physical topology. After reaching a logical topology, you will find only two lines, two cables. In this case, all these lines in the middle are wasted and unusable. So what will happen after stacking? Stacking means taking this physically independent switch, realize logical unification. You can think of it as, I have stacked all the access layer switches below. After stacking, from a logical perspective, it appears as one unit. You can understand that its control plane is unified. In this way, I can let the upper and lower parts both act as this stack. Then, in the switches of the upper and lower parts, the link aggregation will be done in the middle. So we know that this link aggregation actually needs to be. The requirement for link aggregation is that both sides have the same equipment. Only then can link aggregation be performed. After stacking, it becomes one device. At this point, I can either believe this. I can turn this topology into this shape, where the middle is a link aggregation line, and both above and below are switches. What are the benefits of this? The first one. Compared to traditional networks, where bandwidth would be wasted, now I can achieve 100% bandwidth utilization. Secondly, it's me, I don't need to converge anymore, because it's just a device. I don't have this need to converge, STV convergence. The last one simplified operational management and reduced it. Cost. So what does this mean? That is, once my control plane is unified, I can easily access anyone. For this device, you can use console, telnet, or SSH, for example. I actually configured all the configurations for this switch, right? As long as I put these 5 devices together, like how I treat this stage equipment in the middle, so I can enter any console port or any telnet port. In fact, it's all about configuring the same device. So in this way, I can turn it into a unified configuration interface to reduce the operation and maintenance costs. Also, for our S series switches, they support stacking with stack cards and service ports. When stacking cards for stacking, we can stack using this dedicated stacking card and the dedicated stacking cable. In this way, it is also possible to stack through this business port. So, what are the benefits of these two? By using stacking cards for stacking, I can save bandwidth and handle the quantity of both the physical and business ports. So if you adopt this, if using service ports for stacking, you may need to waste a few interfaces, but you won't need to purchase this additional stacking card. As well as this stacked cabling, each has its own pros and cons. Each has its own pros and cons. Okay. Also, we support a super virtualized HCIA data center network for this SVF. So what does this mean? As you can see, we can divide this topology into a core switch, an aggregation switch, and an access switch, right? So what is SVF? SVF is a vertical virtualization, which means that after adopting this SVF, my access switch, it can become one of these core or aggregation switches. This interface version, it only serves as the access point for this port. It does not perform this. It does not perform this control. Its control plane is managed uniformly by the core or aggregation switches above. In this way, it simplifies the operation and maintenance. One of our high reliability features is our support for this 5 nines high reliability, which includes this redundancy of business components. You can see the redundancy of the power module and the fan module, and it supports hot swap. It also supports this OIM supports end-to-end detection, and also supports G8032. interconnecting signals to support this multi-ring, multi-domain network, a network. So it also supports this type of lightning protection. The new generation of this SEP features this ring network protection technology. Broken, still supporting this smart link. This smart link is mainly to solve this dual homing. In this case, a single circuit has this fault, a fault issue. So in this case, it's a holistic one for us. The content. We can have a brief understanding. This is our original summary, product positioning, some board module functions, and some special features, etc. Above is an introduction to our S switch. So everyone, if the customer is interested, they can also go check this out. Our learning website, the Learning Support Case Library, allows us to do this. Expand our understanding of this to an S switch. Okay, so that's all for this session of the course. Thank you, everyone.